Last time we talked about generating an ABAP unit test class for a class object. Now let's do the same for a CDS view. In the Project Explorer, right-click on the CDS view. Select Joule, then New ABAP Test Class to start the wizard. On the first page, you'll be asked to provide some basic information, including the name and the description of the test class. On the next screen, you can see the dependencies for which test doubles will be created using the CDS test double framework. This process safeguards the original data in the CDS view. All dependencies are automatically detected. In the next step, you'll be presented with the test case suggestions that are grouped according to the different CDS semantics used within the CDS view. You have the option to choose specific test cases for which you would like to create test data and test methods. The wizard displays the test cases. For example, the calculation test case includes three different methods that could be generated. Furthermore, it provides suggestions for the test case, cast, join, and where. In this stage of the wizard, when you select a suggested test case, you can access its description and the test method name. The description explains the purpose of the test case and remains unchanged, promoting consistency and clarity about the test objects. In contrast, the test method name is editable, which is particularly useful if the automatically generated name exceeds character limits. This ability to rename methods provides practical and concise naming that aligns with your specific conventions and requirements while maintaining consistency in testing objectives. Continuing on with the next step of the wizard, you have the opportunity to select the test cases for which test data and methods will automatically be generated in the subsequent step. In this example, we chose to select all provided suggested test cases. As you move to the next screen, you'll generate test data based on the selected test cases. You are able to review the generated test data in addition to the generated test case. The test data for the test dependencies is also created. Notice that in the generated test data, the carrier ID in this flight dependency doesn't match the carrier ID in carriers. This test data effectively fulfills the test goal we aim to achieve. Beneath the preview of the test data, you can examine the expected test output for the tested CDS entity. In this scenario, the test result should be empty because the conditions are joined with an AND operator. This means that all conditions must be met for the output to be otherwise. Thus, the test effectively illustrates the behavior of the CDS entity under the specific parameters. In the final step, choose a transport request to record the changes for the test class, including all the defined test cases that will be generated. After completing all the wizard steps, the test class for our CDS view is generated.